Let's see problem number 17. Okay, the output Y of the circuit shown is. Okay, this is a circuit shown. This is a NOR gate. This is also NOR gate. Okay, it's a common. So, hum logon ne, we have made the gate. So, the output of this, it is acting as NOT gate. Okay, NOR gate is acting as NOT gate because we are giving the single input. So, it's giving A bar here, B bar. So, if we'll give A bar, B bar, and this is also once again NOR gate. So, for NOR output, there must be Y is equal to A and B. A plus B. Okay, A or B and should be bar. I think C is the correct option. For D, the output of given logic gate is. Okay, what would be the output for this NOR gate? The output for this would be A and B. So, it would be A plus B. Okay. And what would be output at this point? The output would be A is taking as an input and C. So, this would be A plus C. And this is AND gate. So, for AND, it would be A plus B and A plus C. Okay. So, option C is the correct option. Like this. Now, the question is, for a given plate, the plate current in a triode is maximum when the potential of. Okay, when the plate current in the triode is going to be. Maximum. When the potential of. Means, obviously, when the potential of grid will increase because the plate are positive. So, okay, the given plate voltage. So, we are giving plate voltage positive. And when the voltage applied to the grid voltage, to the grid, would also, if will increase the grid voltage, okay, then it will raise the current. Obviously, the current will be maximum. The plate current will be maximum. If we'll apply the voltage of grid as well as what? Plate voltage. Positive plate voltage. Okay. So, grid ke liye, grid must be at high potential. Potential uska chada hona chahiye. Okay. Now, see the question number 20. If the voltage between the terminals A and B is 17 volt. Okay. The voltage between the A and B is 17 volt. A and B is suppose 17 volt. This is given the voltage between A and B is 70 volt. Input voltage is 17 volt. Okay. And general background voltage is 9 volt. Okay. This voltage is 9 volt. General breakdown voltage 9 volt at this point. Now, then the potential voltage across the R. So, we will have to find the potential voltage across the R. So, it's simple. We can just, we will minus 17 minus 9 volt, 17 volt minus 9 volt. Okay, input voltage minus general breakdown voltage will give you the voltage across the R. Suppose this is VR. So, VR would be 17 minus 9 volt. 17 is the input voltage VI and minus VZ, Wiener breakdown voltage. Okay, that is VR. So simply 17 minus 9 is 8 volt. So 8 volt is the correct option B. Okay. In the figure shown, okay, there is two figure given, figure A and B. So in both figure A and figure B, the diodes are forward bias. Now just check out which diode is forward bias and which is negative, reverse bias. As this is connected, this B part is connected with the positive. So this plate is more positive. Okay, B is connected to the positive. It means this is the forward bias. Okay, this diode is in forward bias. And if you will see this figure, the negative is connected to the P. Negative is connected to the P. It means this is a reverse bias. Okay. This is a forward bias and this is a reverse bias. Just see, in figure A and figure B, diodes are reverse bias. In figure A, the diode is forward bias, and in figure B, the diode is reverse bias. C is the correct answer. Okay, this is a forward bias configuration, and this is the reverse bias. Now, question number 22. An AC signal of 50 Hz frequency is input of a full wave rectifier using two diodes. The output frequency after full wave rectification is, obviously it is going to be double because there is two cycle, because this is the output frequency. If we will talk about the output frequency, this is the output frequency for the full wave rectifier. Okay. Now, the amplification produced by triode is due to the action of obviously grid, because when we increase the grid potential, the current will also increase. Okay, so grid amplification, for amplification grid produce important role, because we are giving signal to the grid. Okay, the output form. Question number 24, the output from a full wave rectifier is obviously a pulsating DC, because it's not give the pure DC. Okay, there is some ripples remaining after even full wave rectification. So this pulsating kind of things can be removed by adding the filter. Okay, question number 25, which of the following metal thermodynamically emit an electrons at a relatively lowest temperature among them? Obviously, which will take the lowest temperature to emit the electrons? Okay, obviously those are having less electron in outermost shell or outermost orbit will emit the electron fast. So if you will see this moly, this D molybdenum is having one electron in outermost orbit. Okay, this is having only one electron in outermost orbit, so obviously this will emit thermonically faster than rest of these, because aluminium having three in outermost orbit, similarly copper having. So this is the correct option, D is having one electron in outermost orbit. Okay, that is MO is having one electron in outermost orbit. Okay, so let's see question number 26. Question number 26, which of the following circuit will not show the current in the ammeter. Let's check the circuit. Okay, this is connected to the positive terminal, this is connected to the negative terminal. If this this positive plate is connected to the negative terminal, it means diode will not conduct. It will behave like a, it will offer a resistance. So if diode will not not conduct, the current will not flow. If current will not flow, then how it will show in ammeter? So I think A is the correct option. Let's check another rest of the circuit. If you see, this is the forward bias, P is connected to the positive plate, further this is also in forward bias. Okay, so this diode will conduct, and whatever current will flow through these diodes or this circuit, it will show in ammeter. Okay, similarly this diode is, this diode is forward bias. If this would be the path of current, this would be the path of current. Okay, the current will flow like this and it will show the current in ammeter. And this both diode are, this is the flow of current because the diode is connected at forward bias. Okay, so option A is correct. In this circuit, the current will not show in ammeter. Let's see question number 27. In the figure shown below, which of the diode are forward biased? Let's check one by one. So this positive terminal, ground is connected to the positive, 0 volt is connected to the P positive, and this positive is connected to the N. So this is the reverse bias. Now check the figure number 2. This positive plate is connected to the plus 10 volt. So this is the forward bias. Okay. So let's see the next. This is negative voltage compared with, if you are comparing with the P, this is not the forward bias. So now minus 10 volt to the N and minus 5 volt to the P. Okay, P side is connected compared to the minus 5 volt. So this is going to be the forward bias. This is also a forward bias. And if you will see, 0 in compare with and this is minus 10 volt to the N side and this is 0 volt. So this can be also forward bias. Okay. This can be also forward bias because it's more negative. So I think option B is the correct option. Now question number 28. A Zener diode is used for, Zener diode is being used for the voltage regulation. Okay, so option D is, it is known as the voltage regulator. Okay, question number 29. In the figure, the input across the terminal A and C are the output across the B and D. Obviously, input across the A and C, this and this, we are providing the input. Okay, and we are getting output from the B and D. So this will act as a full wave rectifier. So option C is correct option. It will act as a Let's see question number 30. The forbidden energy gap in germanium is 0.72 electron volt given. Sc is 12,400 electron volt angstrom. Okay. The maximum wavelength of radiation that will generate electrons whole pair is. Okay. We have to find the wavelength. Okay. We are having the formula for the forbidden gap, energy gap. Okay. That is Eg is equal to Hc by lambda. And we have to find the wavelength at lambda. So lambda is equal to Hc by Eg. Okay. Hc is given. This is Hc is given 12,400. So put the value of Hc 12,400 divided by energy. Energy is given 0.72 electron volt. Isn't it? Yeah, it is 0.72. And after solving that, we will get 17,222. Okay, angstrom. Okay, this is a simple formula. We are knowing the formula. Energy is equal to Sc by lambda, and lambda, from this we can calculate the lambda. Lambda is equal to Sc by E. Sc is given, lambda energy is also given. So put the value and get the output. Get the result, that is 17,222 angstrom. So option C is the correct option for this. Okay.